A true national is one whose blood grooms get up while the national anthem is being played. Very good afternoon to all, respected jury members, estimated teachers, and my dear friends who are bored from this debate competition. I am just talking for 5 minutes. I want that everyone should give attention to the debate. Thank you. So, before starting this, my topic is I am against the motion of playing national anthem in the theaters. So before starting it, I would like to ask you that, what is your opinion? Some will say that they are for the motion, and some will say that they are against the motion. I respect everyone's opinion, but my opinion is that national anthem should not be played in the cinema halls. The reason behind this are too much. First reason is that when national anthem is being played, it is compulsory that everyone should stand up and stand in an attention position to give respect to the national anthem. If we are not standing in the attention position, it means we are disrespecting our national anthem. And if we are respecting its national anthem, it means we are disrespecting the struggle of our freedom fighter. We are disrespecting the people who had struggled for the freedom of our country, who had given their lives for our country, the soldiers who are standing on the borders for us, because of whom we are safe in our country. We are disrespecting them. Then it is better not to sing a national anthem in theaters than it disrespecting. Okay. Making anyone stand forcefully for the national anthem is really disrespecting. Patriotism, it should come from our heart. Not anyone should force us. If we have respect to our national anthem, then no need to show everyone that we have respect to our national anthem. If we love our school, as we are saying to everyone that I love my school, we are not showing that. It should come. We should do something for our country, not to just sing national anthem and stand for 52 seconds. Some may say that first 52 seconds, we can stand for 52 seconds. That's not the matter. But for 52 seconds, the feeling should come from our heart, not just for forcefully we have to stand there. 52 seconds, we can stand for 52 seconds, that's not the matter. But what's the matter? That feeling should come from our heart, not that anyone should say to us that stand up and just say. In theaters, many people are coming, some may be drunk, some may be drugged, they are in hangover. And in such a condition, if they are not standing, means it is disrespecting of our national anthem. Supreme Court had given this order that national anthem should be played in cinema halls. That their intention is that our people, our country people, they should think about our country. Because as days are going, as generation is going forwards, everyone are just being selfish. They only want one job, one nice home, and just a simple life. So that government want that our new generation should come forward and they can do something for our country, that our country should develop. I think it is, their opinion is good, very nice, but compulsion should be at colleges, school level, because they are the future of our country. If we are playing it in theaters and everyone is respecting, then not some matter. But days are going, 2 years, 3 years are passed, but still now people are not respecting. Then Supreme Court had just stopped this order. They should ban on it, that national anthem should not be played. Because if we are trying is good. If we are trying again and again, one day we will get success. That's not the matter. But again and again, every time if we are losing, then it's better not to play it in the cinema halls. So I think that you should also think about my opinion. Really, it is good. It is good to play, but the respect should come from our heart, not unrespectfully. We cannot sing our national anthem and we cannot disrespect it. So, if we don't want to give respect, it's better not to sing it. Then, why we are showing that? We are saying on 15th of August and 26th of January we are wearing nice white uniform, we are singing national anthem, most of the people are giving sending status in WhatsApp, Facebook, everything, happy Independence Day, one nice proverbs, everything. But for that day only, it should come from our heart, not we have to show for our country. We have to do something for our country. And I think there should be no compulsion for cinema hall and theaters. I all the best all of you for just who had not then, and thank you.
Thank you. Topic number 11, next participant, Nimish Janai, for the topic.
A very fresh and healthy morning to one and all present here. To survive in peace and harmony, to be united and strong, we need to have one perspective, one flag, one nation, and one national anthem. A great vision is like a great national anthem. It's an inspiration to the people of the country, irrespective to the religion they belong to. And that is why I am such a staunch supporter of national anthem being played in cinema halls and in public places. When we sing our national anthem, we are reminded of our identity of being an Indian. It has the power to emotionally connect us and even inspire us to do great things. It inculcates the sense of integrity and even patriotism. A nation's culture resides in the hearts and the souls of the people. The art of civilization is to march along despite having differences. When we march along despite having any differences, I post a simple and straight argument in front of all my fellow debaters. If the children in village can stand up in mud, can stand up in garbage heaps, can stand up in stables for 52 glorious seconds of the national anthem, what problem does the nation have to stand in cinema halls for 52 glorious seconds of the national anthem? Every child of nursery knows, foundation creates founders. In school, the singing of national anthem is on the peak of their voice. Why does the nation even feel ashamed to murmur it in the cinema halls? Why is this hypocrisy? Or have we lost our independence and even this time to modernization? Fellow debaters, you might think that national anthem should not be played in entertainment places. It needs a proper place to be played. Then, why from 72 years, 103 constitutional amendments, 18 elections, why is the government hesitant to bring the fact national anthem should not be played in sports complexes? Aren't those the places of recreation? You must have heard your teachers saying, this class shares a strong bond, lot of unity. Each class has set example to the world. Let this be our collective dream. May the singing of national anthem in cinema halls cherish our souls, imbibe oneness in us. Let's unite the 1.3 people of India. Let's take a small step to bring the unity of the diverse nation. I would like to share a report by Tata Motors. Recently, it had invited some of its buyers from different places to a particular place, and it had played the national anthem there. And each and every person sitting there, I repeat, each and every person sitting there had stood up and had given respect to the national anthem. If this group can give respect and bring unity, surely this group can. Now, the question arises, does national anthem really bring unity amongst us? Believe me, fellow debaters, it surely will bring unity amongst us. The village of Charapatna, it used to have many inter and intra-caste conflicts. There used to be hundreds of riots, misunderstandings, which polluted the city with negative energies and bad omens. One day, the village serpents decided to play the national anthem every hour. And in 2008, the same village was awarded the prize of the most peaceful village of India. Let this be our collective dream. Let's curb all the obnoxious activities present today. Let's imbibe the spirit of oneness in us. Let's get the unity of India. Let's show the world what is the national anthem. Let's show the world what is India. How is it united? I would like to share a quote in front of you. The more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.
Thank you. Token number 12, Vaidehi Sriram. Further topic.
Do you speak in Assami or Malayalam? Do you prefer chapatis or rice? Do you kneel the namaz, perform the aarti, or do the sign of cross, or believe in no religions? Such a thing define who are you. Within a diverse, that tiger invoked in his Jana Gana Mana, a beautiful national anthem. Respected chairperson, honorable judges, timekeepers, my worthy opponents, and honorable judges. Good evening. Today, I, Vaidehi Sriram, will speak in favor of the motion that playing our national anthem in public places like cinema halls, on November 30, 2016, the Supreme Court made it compulsory for theaters to play the national anthem before the movie. In January 2018, the Apex Court modified its own order, saying that playing the national anthem was not compulsory. However, showing respect would be a mandatory if the national anthem was played. Despite, it is no longer being compulsory since 2018. Now, all the movies halls play the national anthem before the movie. I ask therefore my worthy opponents why. Let me tell you. The national anthem, like other national symbol of a country, represents the traditions, history, and beliefs of a nation and its people. Playing the national anthem is a beautiful song that we are singing, but some people are not singing it. Why? I don't know. Can you tell me? It is a reflex in the every Indian to play the national anthem. Whenever you hear it, the feeling of patriotism also comes. When we hear our national anthem, rises goosebumps and undoubtedly. So my dear friends, today we will sing our national anthem without any fear and salute our nation. Thank you.
Srushti Mane, against the topic.
Honorable Chairperson, learned judges, respected teachers, and all my dear peers, in the opinion of this august house, the topic for today's debate is playing our national anthem in public places like cinema halls solves the purpose to instill the fervor of national unity in the minds of citizens. I stand here in front of you to put forth my views in the opposition of the motion. I heard my worthy opponents using very bombastic and passionate arguments in the favor of playing our national anthem in cinema halls. But I strongly refute the statement of my opponents. Learned judges, let's not allow our minds and rationale to be overclouded by these passionate pleas. If we think dispassionately, we will find that patriotism is a feeling which comes from within, not without. The modern times, when callousness and cynicism have become the order of the day, will the playing of national anthem instill a sense of nationalistic fervor in their hearts of ongoers? The hearts which have grown insular to such often heard patriotic nations, the arguments of my opponents remind of the English proverb, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. Same is the case in point here. The common prevalent public sentiment is that after paying a hefty price for the tickets in search of some light movements and escape from the harsh reality, why should one be forced to stand for the national anthem in cinema halls? Surely anyone with the least bit of common sense will agree with me. There is the right place and right time for everything. Cinema hall is a place where public goes with a view to seek entertainment, some thrill, not prove its national allegiance. Also, the purpose is defeated because cineviewers throw all protocols by remaining firmly seated in their seats, paying no heed to the national anthem. My worthy opponents, let's be realistic. I strongly urge that stop being hypocrites. We don't need to wear our patriotism on our sleeves. It is direct infringement of our rights to privacy as we go to cinema halls in personal capacity. Cinema hall is a mass media which is most sought after for its entertainment value. Let's keep the commutative of the masses while they go to watch a movie. If we understand this basic fact, then the reality will dawn upon us. Instead of achieving any great goal, we are doing a great disservice to the national anthem by playing it at the wrong place and at the wrong time. Let's stop this charade of promoting patriotism by enforcing national anthem to be played in cinema halls. Last but not the least is that national anthem is ought to be played only in open places and not under the roof. So ladies and gentlemen, put on your thinking caps and ponder over the sanity of this idea that playing of national anthem instill a sense of nationality. My answer is a firm no. On the contrary, it dilutes the issue. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Next, token number 13, Sharvari Hathe for the topic.
Good afternoon, respected Julies and my dear friends. My name is Sharvari. My topic is playing our national anthem in public place like cinema hall from the motion. According to me, it is good rule by the government that national anthem is compulsory within the all movie theater. Because nowadays all individual person is busy in their own life, running towards the money and their work. So they don't getting time to spend with their or talk with their family members or with their friends. So they have difficulty to remember national anthem. Cinema is place where the people get chance to sing national anthem before the movie. Cinema is place where the people at least plan once to watch movie with their loved ones or with their family members. So there is a different type of people gathered together and see picture with their loved ones. So it is correct place to play national anthem. There are many good people and good movies that respects our country, but not all people and movies that don't respect our country. So at least they remember national anthem. The person whose mind and heart is clean, then they don't want to discuss the place and people to respect our national anthem. We we spent our lot of time in our lot of activities, but we never thought that we have to give our 52 second of a day to our national anthem. So it's a show that we sing national anthem in school also forcefully. We don't have problem to stand in a line to get popcorns. Then we don't have problem to sing national anthem for 52 seconds. As we say that the many senior citizens have difficulties to standing because they are physically unable people. So according to me, it is good. If we are giving excuses to sing national anthem, then we are do not have a right to be known as the Indian citizen. It doesn't show if we are standing for a national anthem. If we are standing for a national anthem, it doesn't make us Indian. We are posting flags on social medias. It doesn't make us Indian. The national anthem comes from our heart and our mind. Thank you.
Next, Ananya Vyas. Against the topic.
Good morning, respected chairperson, honorable judges, my worthy opponents and the august gathering. Today, I, Ananya Vyas, will be speaking against the motion. Playing the national anthem in public places like cinema halls solves the purpose to instill the fervor of national unity in the citizen's mind. What is national unity then? National unity is the acceptance of different groups of people coming together, working together, and living together. And the love for our nation is patriotism. Patriotism is not simply waving the flag, but let's not demean the term by ever suggesting that it is nothing more than just a sign. Has national unity become so meaningless that just a few actions, feelings, and just singing the national anthem make us feel united and patriotic? I don't think so. Then tell me, how does playing the national anthem in public places like cinema halls make each and every individual feel patriotic from within and united? Playing the national anthem can be mandated in schools, colleges, organizations, etc. But the love and respect for our national anthem should come from within. Has the government become so How can they dilute the importance of the national anthem? But there is no guarantee that this move will instill the sense of unity amongst the people. Rabindranath Tagore, the writer of our national anthem, once said, "I will never let patriotism triumph over humanity as long as I live." When something is forced, we tend to lose respect for it. Just like that, patriotism is something that cannot be forced. It should come from within. Does wearing patriotism on one's sleeve feel like the best way to show our love and respect for our motherland? We all are growing up listening to the national anthem in our schools at various occasions. It is a beautiful and powerful song which encompasses and evokes a feeling of pride within us. And it must be sung whilst maintaining the proper code of conduct. Playing it at frivolous events is not only irresponsible, but is also disrespectful to the very idea of the national anthem, the song of the highest honor in our country. So playing it before any sort of film seems out of place. India is a country with diverse languages, cultures, and beliefs. But what is the point of playing the national anthem in these public places if we all are so divided on basis of political views, religions, faiths, and whatnot? We as Indians should welcome our fellow countrymen with open arms warmth and concern. We should avoid discrimination and we should be tolerant towards others. The sense of cohesiveness has to be established and a common goal has to be developed. Only then can we say that the national anthem unites us all. Simply singing it in the cinema halls or public places for 52 seconds and then going back to disliking your neighbors and countrymen just because of their beliefs? I don't think this is how the national anthem unites us. In my opinion, playing the national anthem in public places or cinema halls is actually unnecessary, as there are some people who disrespect their national anthem. Some people talk to their friends, fiddle on their phones, and unfortunately, there are some people who think it is better to enter the hall right after the conclusion of the national anthem. There have been so many cases of these disrespecting. The case versus on Kerala for the three children who did not do this on purpose, but they were still imprisoned. But still, there is no change. There are many people who've laid down their lives just to protect us and this country. And I don't think that would have been possible if there was no unity between them. To conclude, I would just like to say that I do not think that playing the national anthem in public places like cinema halls solves the purpose to instill the fervor of national unity in a citizen's mind. Thank you.
Our next participant, token number 14, Swara Singh, for the topic.
A very fanatic good afternoon, respected judges, teachers and all my dear friends. This is Swara Nisal from School of Scholars Atri, and my topic is singing national anthem in public places instill the purpose of unity in the minds of citizens. National anthem develops and evokes the feeling of patriotism and reminds them our nation's glory, beauty, rich culture and heritage. Our national anthem also develops a competitive spirit with other countries. Our national anthem was written on 11 December 1911 and was declared as a national anthem on 21st Jan 1915. And our national anthem also connects and relates our country spiritually and philosophically. Our country also includes unity in diversity. So it also unites our country. What is wrong in singing our national anthem, who gave us name? What's wrong in giving respect to our motherland who gave us name? Show respect to your national anthem, no matters it is sung at public places or any other way. National anthem, our anthem evokes us, our anthem unites us, our anthem inspires us, our anthem teaches culture, our anthem teaches manner, our anthem shows unity in diversity, our anthem is our strength, our anthem shows high energy towards our enemy. Show respect to our national anthem. What is the problem? We should give respect to our motherland who gave us name. Anytime if we sing our national anthem, it's an honor to us and our hearts should beat out of our chest. Today, there is no law and order that national anthem can't be sung at any public place. Whereas on November 30, 2016, the government have declared that before screening any film, national anthem is mandatory and everyone should stand in respect and maintain a proper decorum. Even at 1971, National Honor Act was passed to save and does not get insert of national anthem. Our national anthem is a first meal to our soul. Our national anthem is a first meal to our soul. The day when India will awake, the day when India will arise, the day when we realize our responsibility, the day we start working hard, the face of our nation will change. And to change, let's hold our hand together, hold even harder, and do what India was born to do. To develop love, to develop respect, and to generate peace. It is not a duty, but a responsibility to respect our national anthem. If we can teach ABCD 1, 2, 3, 4 to the small kids, what is the reason why we can't teach the meaning of a national anthem? We have many examples of other countries like Germany and Japan, how they love their country. Like Germany and Japan, they wear their traditional dresses, they speak their mother tongue, they follow their culture. That's the spirit of love towards the nation. We should also do the same. I'm not talking that we are diverse. I'm talking that we are united. I would like to end my say by saying, a great vision is like national anthem, who have power to pull together and emotionally connect and inspire great things. I would like to end. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Next, Tanisha Thakur. Tanish Thakur. Against the topic.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to speak against the motion. And why should we play the national anthems in cinema halls? Cinema halls are not the place to play the national anthem because people come there for their entertainment and to relieve their stress. It is not the place to sing the national anthem because people are going to enjoy it and then they'll not even remember that they sang the national anthem in the theater. As per my experiences, I saw a teenager a couple days ago in a movie, when I went for a movie, and he was completely sitting throughout the national anthem. It is disrespectful, disrespectful for the national anthem. And even when the national anthem is played in the cinema halls have roofs, and we should not play national anthems under the roof because it is not respectful for the. We cannot just directly switch on our patriotism as per the condition. It has to come from within. We cannot just have the patriotism all throughout the when we start national anthem, and as an Indian citizen, I cannot bear the disrespect of the national anthem when it is played in cinema halls. As people sit for all throughout the 52 seconds of this cinema hall of the national anthem, we can stand for 52 seconds, but you have to respect it too. You have to get the patriotism when the national anthem is played. National anthem should not be played in public places because the people also should be patriotic towards the national anthem. If there's no respect for the national anthem, there's no meaning to sing the national anthem there. With my opinion, I would like to end it. Thank you.
Next, token number 16. Sambhavi Rai, further topic.
Good morning, honorable judges, respected teachers, and my dear friends. I, Sambhavi Rai, today is going to speak in the motion of the topic, playing national anthem in public places like cinema halls solve the purpose to instill the fervor of national unity in the mindsets of people. Nationality spreads when people begin to believe that they are all parts of the same nation. And this binding force must take roots in the hearts and minds of the people before it actually binds the entire country in the spirit of oneness. Through our united struggles for freedom for our motherland, national symbols gradually came into existence, like national images, the tricolor flag, and the crowning glory, the national anthem, Janagana Mana, written by the Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore in Bengali and Sanskrit. This is a part of a long patriotic song. The first five stanza, sung in 52 seconds, had been first published on December 11, 1911. It underlines the importance of India as a diverse nation. It signifies that, despite difference in culture, traditions, religions, and language, India is united under one flag. The anthem is significant for uniting people and reminding us, we, the people of India, remain as one under the Indian Union. Our anthem was first sung on 27 December 1911 at the Calcutta session of the Indian National Congress. The national anthem, like other national symbols of a country, represents the traditions and beliefs of the nation and its people. Hence, it evokes the feelings of patriotism amongst the citizens and reminds them of their glory, beauty, and rich heritage, and is an important aspect in a sovereign state. This anthem is mostly sung during any important national days and military honors, which also serves as an identity and unifying factor of a country. Our anthem unites people of the country and rekindles the spirit of nationalism. Those 52 seconds of rhythmic proclamation of love and respect to this beautiful country, and we are once again reminded of how we won this free air that we breathe and the dignity with which we walk on this land. This showcasing of our glorious past reminds us of our united struggles which finally brought us our freedom. And as we sing in one voice, it revives the feeling of unity. And only in unity lies strength. My question is, does the entire 1.3 billion of Indian citizens know the national anthem? Think of the large number of people who are not attached to any institution. Do they get opportunity to ever learn or sing the anthem with the feeling of love and pride? For them particularly, it is important that the anthem be played and sung in cinema halls and other public places. Let us remind ourselves that a fragmented country is easy fodder for the enemy countries. Let us often remind ourselves the very reason for our colonization had been fragmentation, disunity, and weak loyalties. In a country of diversity like India, it is important to remember the purpose of creating national symbols, and particularly the national anthem when we sing in unison. This singing of national anthem will take the country as a republic towards progress and as a large, strong team. A very recent example of national integration is the abrogation of Article 370, and thereby making Jammu and Kashmir, including Ladakh, a part of the Union of India as any other state or union territory. The state of Jammu and Kashmir, which earlier had a separate flag, now hoists the Indian tricolour. This is in pursuance of the Prime Minister's call of Ek Vidhan, Ek Nishan, Ek Pradhan, and we may add Ek Rashtragan, implying thereby that the entire country of India should have one symbol and one constitution indicating the national tricolour. The two instruments of national integration are the national anthem and the national tricolour. Let us recall the passion in the hearts of every true Indian when India wins a cricket match in another country or receives a medal in Olympics or during any other international game. Is there any need to describe the giant waves of happiness that surge in the hearts of Indians? And this victory is completely realized when a tricolour is gradually raised to the tune of a national anthem. What else can connect every Indian emotionally other than the sound of Janagana Mana Adhinayak Jai? Thank you.
Next participant, Nandini Bitra. Against the topic.
Headlines in the Hitwad. Fight breaks out in the cinema hall over playing the anthem. Fight? It seems that some patriotic people were troubled to see a man seated during the playing of an anthem. As it turned out, the poor man was handicapped and wasn't less of a patriot for not wanting to stand up for the anthem.
Good afternoon, honorable members of the jury, my worthy opponents and members of the audience. I, Nandini, stand before you to speak firmly against the motion. Playing of the national anthem in public places like cinema halls instills a fervor of national unity in the minds of citizens. I respectfully beg to differ. Why I put it to you? Why should the playing of an anthem be a yardstick for my patriotism? I may be a law-abiding citizen. I may pay my taxes on time. I may even defend the nation in uniform. Are all these things zip, zero, zilch when measured against me playing or not playing the anthem? Pause and ponder. Think, think, think. Such an emotive issue must be handled rationally, with logic. Let us not allow our emotions and sentiments to cloud the issue. Our national anthem is merely a means to an end. To put it simply, it was composed to achieve the objective of instilling patriotism among Indians. But I ask you, my worthy opponents, I want you to answer me. I demand an explanation. When patriotism already exists, then why pray? Why should we behave like silly sheep being shepherded by a sheep dog? Let me clarify my stand. Patriotism can and does exist with or without a song or a flag. It exists in the minds and hearts of the people. We do not need an external stimulus to remind us for our love for a nation. I am an Indian and I'm proud to be an Indian. So what if I play the anthem in the privacy of my home? If I choose not to wear my heart on my sleeve, I refuse to be judged by the so-called guardians of the country with their cobweb thinking. A history lesson. National anthems were associated with freedom movements throughout Europe in the 18th, 19th and 20th century. At that moment, there was a need to unite people based on the common language, culture, and history. It made France, Italy, Britain began thus. Asia soon saw its own national movements. It made sense to speak of nationalism then. I emphasize the word then. We are the citizens of the 21st century. Yes, I am a citizen of India and also the citizen of the world. I do not become less of an Indian if I don't honor an anthem. The time for such shallow emotions has passed. Let us take a wise, mature perspective. Marshall McLuhan's Global Village has now come true. The world is ours, and we do not need a few verses to prove it. Empty talk, you say? Allow me to substantiate my argument. How do we wish to instill patriotic fervor in Indians? By coming together as one, forgetting petty differences of color, caste, creed, and religion. By taking up real issues like cleanliness and pollution. By agreeing to make our country an economic superpower. By fighting corruption together as Indians. By participating in elections and bringing dedicated leaders to power. That is how we can do it. Make no mistake, I'm not against our wonderful Jana Gana Mana. But my beloved audience, patriotism and national fervor can be instilled in more ways than one. My honorable jury, ladies and gentlemen, and children, before you go to bed tonight, pledge to become honest, upright, and hard-working citizens. National unity and fervor will follow naturally. Thank you.
Our next participant, token number 19, Riya Bagchi. Against the topic.
Unity can come when there is better coordination and mutual understanding in the society, when there is no fiction of thoughts and clash of ideologies. But when destruction is the motive, unity is dangerous. A very fresh good morning to one and all present here. My worthy opponents who just spoke for the motion did put forward their point of view for us to ponder on. However, I prefer to speak against the motion to validate the important point that the spirit of unity isn't solely dependent upon the playing or the singing of the national anthem. But before jumping to any conclusions, let us analyze a few suggestions that need to be highlighted. India is a country of rich culture and heritage, and in spite of its wide diversity, it operates as a single entity. This is because moral, social, and ethical values have always been prioritized and cautiously practiced from the ancient times. This fact is strongly supported by our historical evidences and ancient scriptures. Thus, the spirit of unity has been in the country's genetic code long before the anthem was written or sung. This spirit was so strongly imbibed and etched in our hearts and souls that from ages we have sustained and overcome invasions, wars, atrocities, malpractices, etc. We need not look further to agree on this, as our history books and records validate the same. Now, I would like to state some data which my opponents will definitely agree on. Our national anthem was officially adopted by the Constituent Assembly on 24 January 1950. So, it's evident that it was after this date that the citizens of India took up the singing of the national anthem on a mass scale. But prior to this, our country witnessed a historical moment wherein it achieved independence in 1947 from the 200 years of British rule. Our long struggle of independence was based on hardcore spirit of unity and, of course, in the absence of the anthem. The point to be stressed upon is that the national anthem is a lyrical component towards of encouragement towards the spirit of unity, but not the only thing on which unity stands upon. Coming to the present day scenario, cinema halls are places of entertainment, and there is a different mood in which one enters the theater. While I do not condemn the playing of the national anthem, I do believe that the environment isn't conducive for playing something as pure and as sober as our anthem. Our anthem, like other national symbols, represents tradition, history, and belief of a nation and its citizen. And hence, it helps evoke feelings of patriotism in a citizen's hearts and minds, and reminds them of their country's nation, country's glory, beauty, and rich heritage. And hence, it should be practiced in educational setups, sports meets, places of national integration, etc. Singing of the national anthem in a dark hall with a tub of popcorns in one hand and a glass of soft drink in another doesn't really encourage patriotism. I surely do believe that the guardians of the Supreme Court, by modifying the law of making the playing of the national anthem from mandatory too optional, will hereby preserve the dignity and purity of the spirit of the anthem. Indians will cherish and follow noble ideas towards building a just society. There are n number of anecdotes where Indians have stood together in hard times, may it be Kargil or Indochina war or even war against terrorism. We uphold and protect sovereignty, unity, and integrity of our country, not by singing the national anthem, but by administrating our duties, striving for excellence, and taking our country a new stride of endeavor. Thank you.
Token number 20, Pranav Kshirsagar.
Good morning to all. I, Pranav Kshirsagar, representative of Gayakwad Patil International School, is going to tell you, share my views about why should we play national anthem in cinema halls. Cinema hall, the place of where we view movies, see things which inspire us, and eat popcorns and drink some soft drinks. So, first, what do? When we go inside the theater, we sing the national anthem. Our first and our last song we will sing till our last breath. The national anthem builds to pride and to feel your hearts into skies and sing that why we should sing national anthems. National anthem is the one song that inspire me, inspire all of you. Our India, with the agricultural land, fertile land, and everything is in our India. There are all four environments in India: desert, ice, tropical, and temperate. The four main agricultural lands and everything are in our country. So why we should not sing national anthem for them, for our people? Before seeing movies, why we should sing national anthems? Before why we should sing national anthems? Movie. Why? What is mean by movie? Is that inspire us? Did you really inspired by a movie or playing like superhero here or there in parks and throwing things everywhere? Can't you ever imagine that if we sing our national anthem, we will get really patriotic and we will be very, 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 very proud of our nation. Our nation is very heritage and very disciplined, that even in Supreme Court has declared that before seeing movies, national anthem is compulsory and mandatory. I request all the debaters which are against me, why will you sing national anthem? I ask you, why will you sing national anthem? If you don't want to sing the national anthem before movies, you don't sing. I will not force you. But when you sing national anthem in schools or in your places where you regularly did that national anthem, why did you think that national anthem is compulsory? Did you think? If you think, please, I request you to sing national anthem before movies, because seeing that flag waving in our sky, blue sky, feels that patriotism is in my heart. So I request everyone to please sing national anthem before seeing the movies. National anthem is very important to our country, because in our country there are so many people who doesn't stand for national anthem and disrespecting our nation. But why are they disrespecting? Because today's generation is very rude and angry that we should do like this chatting on Instagram, Facebook. This is the condition of our nation. We will stand for 1 hour chatting with our friend in buses and everywhere, but not for 52 seconds for our national anthem. So together, please stand and sing national anthem for everybody else. Thank you.
Now here comes our last candidate of this debate competition, Advaika Lomde. Advika Londe.
Good morning, one and all. I, Advika Londe, daughter of retired Major Sandeep Londe, salute all the well-meaning patriots seated here. As I proceed to speak against the motion that playing national anthem in public places will instill national unity in the minds of citizens. I grew up listening to the fascinating stories of Kargil War, of which my father was a part. Till date, neither my father nor his army friends label themselves as patriots just because they were a part of Op Vijay. They call themselves true Indians when they step aside to give way to an ambulance, when they follow rules meant for Indians, and when they stand up to defend their country against any anti-nationalist statement or act. The Indian Armed Forces, probably the most heterogeneous Indian group, does not sing the national anthem on a daily basis. Surprisingly, at the unit level, they don't even sing it on 15th August and 26th Jan. And yet, in their call of duty, they fiercely display their national unity and won't hesitate to lay their lives for their country. Point taken, soldiers. Action is important than lip service. Indians stood united on quite a few fronts. The Kerala floods, trying for Kulbhushan's safe return,
the Balakot airstrike, Wing Commander Abhinandan's safe return, the Chandrayaan and World Championship of PV Sindhu. Just one query. Did we play our national anthem at any of these events? No, we didn't. Except at the World Championship when Sindhu received her medal. And everyone was as choked as Sindhu. Not because of the anthem, but because of the achievement. And these achievements are the outcome of the feelings of patriotism that rest within every citizen's soul. We don't need an anthem to display either our unity or our patriotism. An anthem, by definition, is a song of representing. It's not a song that would induce patriotism in people. Moving further with the topic, the school children sing national anthem almost on a daily basis 10 years of their life. And that too at a very impressionable age. Yet, can we guarantee that these students grow up to be law-abiding citizens, true nationalists, or in the real definition, followers of national unity? Everybody has doubts, but time will tell. Okay, now imagine a guy comfortably plumped up in his recliner seat with a popcorn tub in one hand and a Coke tumbler in another. And the national anthem begins. The struggle then is not to inspire patriotism or unity, but to stand up without letting the popcorn spill onto anyone. And this struggle has to be completed in exactly 52 seconds. Why? Because that is the official time required to complete our national anthem. A reality that many Indians are unaware of. Patriotism, a feeling that instills national unity, is like honesty. Either you are honest or you are not. There is no part honesty and there is no part patriotism. The one that can be included in the curriculum. I disown myself from being called an Indian if I have to be compelled to sing the national anthem. It is a prayer that will rise from my being when I feel strongly towards my country and my countrymen. It will be done when I realize that we all have same rights and same rules to follow. When I follow discipline and when I stop criticizing my country, including in spite of my freedom of speech, I stop myself from criticizing my country. When I stand up for any fellow Indian, ignoring our differences. And when I stop myself from underestimating my country under the cute garb of foreign studies and foreign culture. Today, let us pledge to do away with the compulsion of singing our national anthem. Instead, let's instill a feeling of nationality by breaking the narrow domestic walls present within India. Let us proceed towards building a disciplined, dedicated, and a dynamic India. The anthem can wait. Jai Hind!